Good morning, Heidelberg Union Church. Good to see all of you here this morning. Whether you have been here all of your life, or you are worshiping with us for the very first time, or you are joining us virtually, we are glad that you are here to worship our God with us this morning. Happy Father's Day to all the fathers and father figures and those that take on the role as father for young people and older people too. We hope that you have a wonderful day today, but let's take a moment and remember that this day is not easy for everyone. There are people that don't have good role models in their lives, that have been hurt or have had disappointing relationships with people. So we want to hold them in prayer today too, and those that are missing their father figures. Our Father's Day brunch last week was wonderful, I hear. I hear the food was really good and good fellowship. So thank you to our Women of Faith for sponsoring that. Check your bulletin for volunteer opportunities for Vacation Bible School and for the two Pride events coming up. And as a church, we have switched over to Breeze as our online directory. So next week, Sydney will be here at 9:15 a.m. We will be in Fellowship Hall. She'll show you a demonstration of how to use it and how to access things. But it's going to be a wonderful, wonderful thing for our community and to be able to have our directory online. So if you're missing somebody's phone number, you don't have to bother Sydney. You can just check right in and find out that phone number. Next week, we will have an outdoor worship service, so please bring your lawn chairs or your blankets or whatever you would like to sit on outside. We meet right outside near the tree. VBS registration is open. That is July 22nd to the 26th. Information will be in the bulletin next week and in the newsletter. It's also on Facebook, so if you want to get registered early, you can go ahead on Facebook to do that. Some people news. Congratulations are in order and many blessings for Mr. and Mrs. Amaral. They were married yesterday, so we are very excited about that, and we celebrate their union together. They were married at Lehigh University, so it was a wonderful celebration. And Barb is still on hospice care, but she's here, so we're so glad that you're able to come and be with us when you're feeling up to it. Are there any other announcements for the good of the body that I may have missed?
So,
yes.
The out-of-town Pride event on the 30th, we only need 4 volunteers. So if anyone's interested in going online, 4 volunteers are needed. We have a committee set up. We're going to be there as well. So we appreciate anyone that wants to come out. Recruit young people. Come to the church. Welcome people of all ages and backgrounds.
Thank you, Tony. Tony and Carrie and Robin and Amy are all a part of the planning team for that. So thank you for serving in that way, too. Thank you to all of you. Anything else? All right. If not, let us prepare our hearts and minds for worship by listening to our prelude.
Thank you.
Thank you, Judy. One of my favorite movies, Beaches,
yes.
Bette Midler. Oh, thank you for that. Let us get up and greet one another in Christian love, sharing the love we have for one another before we continue. You can come back to where you were. And you can sit down. Yep. We didn't have that in our bulletin this morning, and we love greeting one another. It's such a joyous time here, so I wanted to make sure we added that in so that we could say good morning and peace of Christ. No matter who you are or where you are on life's journey, you are welcome here. Who are we as Christ's church? Together, our vision is welcoming, embracing, giving, celebrating. Together, our mission is no matter who you are, we welcome everyone into our Heidelberg family, embrace the diversity of all people and their ideas, share our time, talent, and treasures with our community, and celebrate each other all through God's love. Friends, during this time of worship, may the Spirit be in this place. May you feel God's loving touch upon you, and may you grow closer in your relationship with Christ. Will you please rise for our call to worship? We have come to worship God, the living Spirit, who calls prophets and teachers to bear witness. We have come to praise God, the Almighty God, who answers the forces of hatred and hurt with the power of grace. We come to worship God, all gracious God, who chooses even you and me to receive and carry the word of life and hope. All glory to God. Our opening hymn is Arise, Your Light Has Come, red hymnal 314 or on the screen. Now is the time for us to have a little conversation with God, to share the things that we aren't so proud of. It is now time for us to share our sins, our regrets, and our wrongdoings, first in silence. Thank you. And now joining our voices together in the prayer of confession. Holy God, the creator of all things based on love, you created us in your image. Our God is a God of love, of grace, and of mercy. Through Jesus Christ and the power of the Holy Spirit, we are a forgiven people. Thanks be to God for a love like that.
The first scripture reading for today is from 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verses 4 through 11. Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are varieties of services, but the same Lord. And there are varieties of activities, but it is the same God who activates all of them in everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. To one is given through the Spirit the utterance of wisdom, and to another the utterance of knowledge according to the same Spirit. To another, faith by the same Spirit. To another, gifts of healing by the one Spirit. To another, the working of powerful deeds. To another, prophecy. To another, the discernment of spirits. To another, various kinds of tongues. To another, the interpretation of tongues. All these are activated by one and the same Spirit, who allots to each one individually, just as the Spirit chooses. And the gospel reading is from the book of Mark, chapter 4, verses 30 to 32. With what can we compare the kingdom of God, or what parable will we use for it? It is like a mustard seed, which, when sown upon the ground, is the smallest of all the seeds on earth. Yet, when it is sown, it grows up and becomes the greatest of all shrubs, and puts forth large branches, so that the birds of the air can make nests in its shade.
Thank you.
please pray with me? Holy and loving God, we want your still speaking voice to touch our hearts, to transform our souls. We want your spirit to be in these words and in the silent meditations of our hearts. And so, Holy One, may everything that I say and do be pleasing to you and have you smile. Amen. So before we dive in today's message, I'd like you to turn to a neighbor, and if you're not sitting with a neighbor, move so that you can be with one. And I'd like you to tell each other what you think of when you hear the words spirit-fueled living. So I'll give you like 1 minute. So turn to a neighbor. What do you think of when you hear the words spirit-fueled living? All right, I hope you had an opportunity to share. Anyone like to share something that they talked about? What do you think spirit-fueled living is?
Helping one another.
Being kind to each other.
Encouraging.
Communicating.
Love.
What was that?
Showing love.
Love, sharing love, yes.
Bringing Barb to church.
Yep. For me, spirit-fueled living is when we acknowledge and we use our diverse gifts in our ordinary, everyday, day-to-day lives. As we follow the leading of the Spirit working together for the common good. And so as we gather together this morning and throughout our summer series, we are going to talk about the transformative power of spirit-fueled living. Some of our members and our friends throughout the summer are going to be sharing their passion stories. Next week, our first one will be Judy. Judy will be sharing her passion story, and it's an amazing story that she already shared with those of you that come to HARP, so you won't want to miss it next week. That's a little plug. But all of our members and friends are going to be sharing the way that the passions that they have in their lives are spirit-filled and how they use their gifts to serve God in so many different ways. So this morning, we begin our journey with the words of Paul in the first letter to the Corinthians. Paul's words remind us that there are a variety of gifts and a variety of services. But the same Spirit and Lord bestows each upon each individual. Each gift, Paul emphasizes, is given by the Spirit, and the Spirit chooses for all to benefit. This letter is an underscore of the fundamental truth about our spiritual lives. The diversity of gifts among us is a testament to the richness of God's grace. Each one of us, with our own unique talents and abilities, we each contribute to the vitality of our community. In our day-to-day lives, these spiritual gifts show up in so many different ways. Not necessarily always in a grand gesture. Sometimes it's just in the simple, ordinary things as we go about our day. Most often, our gifts are just gentle and kind. Think about the gifts of wisdom. It might be compassionate guidance that you offered to a friend, or maybe it's the thoughtful decision-making process that you use that benefits our communities. The gift of healing might be seen in the caring hands of a nurse, or the comforting words of a counselor, or the listening ear of a loved one or a friend. Each gift, no matter how seemingly ordinary, is an expression of the Spirit's work in our lives. And when we share these gifts with one another, we are indeed living Spirit-fueled lives. And the parable of the mustard seed helps us to further understand Spirit-fueled living. Jesus speaks to the transformative potential within each one of us. The mustard seed, though tiny and seemingly insignificant, holds the potential to grow into something mighty and life-giving. Similarly, our spiritual gifts, when nurtured and cultivated, can have a profound impact on those around us. The smallest acts of kindness, the simplest expressions of love, the quiet moments of faithfulness. These are all seeds, seeds that when sown in our communities, grow into the shrubs that sustain us. Now, last weekend, I was with representatives from all four of the Pennsylvania conferences of the United Church of Christ. Now, we are a federated congregation, so that means we have equal standing in the ELCA and the UCC. But last weekend was all about the UCC. The four conferences gathered together because we are coming together as one Pennsylvania conference, the Keystone Conference, as it's called right now. And there was a working group called the Keystone Working Group, which was comprised of four conference ministers, one from each of the conferences in Pennsylvania, and representatives from all four of the conferences. They have been working for 2 years to bring together the four conferences to one body of Christ. Each member of that group used their own gifts. As a team, they worked together to write the resolution, which we will be voting on in November. They wrote a potential constitution and bylaws. They created a staffing model. They created a budget and so much more. All the while, they kept communication open with all of the local clergy and churches to make sure that we knew what was happening in the process. So I, for one, would like to applaud all that they have done for each one of us in this coming together. Using their gifts, they have really done a lot of really good work to help this transition to move smoothly. What I hope happens from this is that our local churches will realize that coming together isn't such a bad thing, because we truly are stronger together than we are apart. So many times we want to hold on to our own community, and we don't realize just how much our gifts would benefit God and our community if we pulled them together and worked together more. As a local church here at Heidelberg, we engage in our own ministries and our missions, and we do so with a deep awareness of the Spirit that is among us, that is constantly guiding us in our decision making and in how we use our gifts. We trust God. We trust God, and for that we are receiving growth and abundance. And we are indeed stronger together because each one of us works together for this community, sharing our own gifts, our talents, and our treasures. And in our individual lives, we might be mindful of the ways that we use our gifts to serve others. Let us seek opportunities to offer wisdom, to help in healing, to share God's love, and to act in faith. We are called to recognize and to celebrate the diverse gifts within our midst and lift one another up so that every voice is heard and we can work together for the common good as the body of Christ. We are called to be a beacon of hope, a living testament to the inclusive and transformative power of God's love. So let us be prophets of justice and compassion, discerning the needs of our community and responding with love. And as we move forward in our ministry and our witness, we do so with hearts open to the Spirit's leading, hands open to serving Christ. Because together we continue to build a community of faith, a community of believers with diverse gifts. Thanks be to God, we aren't all the same. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
Holy One, as we reflect on your word, we have questions. Was Puccini's music for his ears alone, or was Starry Night only for Van Gogh's eyes? Are discerners of spirits better than those who prophesy? Is it better to be a healer than a preacher? Was Mother Teresa more important than the Jesuit brother who held the door? Today we are reminded that all gifts are from the same Spirit. They are each a part of the whole and given to each of us for each other or for the common good. Lord, help us understand. Thank you for all our gifts. Help us to use our gifts for the common good, serving you and our community. Strengthen those who feel faint, give courage to those who fear, and bring wholeness to those in need, especially Mr. and Mrs. Amaral, Cindy and Steve and family, Dawn, Zach, Todd, Tim and Matt, Nathan, Kaylin, Cora, Teddy, Gabe, Barb, the Kenzik family, Barbara, Joanne, Jim, Matt, Corinne and Russell, Mercedes, and Jim and family. For those on the prayer chain, we keep in our prayers, and for those not mentioned, in our hearts. We also pray for our weekly partner in ministry, the Penn Northeast Conference, this week. Bless them as they continue serving Christ in the community and beyond. We pray all of this in the name of Jesus Christ with the prayer he taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
It is now time for us to share the gifts that we have already received from God so that we can further our mission out into the world following Christ. It is now time for our tithes and our offerings.
Thank you.
so we give back to you these tokens of our love and our faithfulness. Multiply them and spread them out to the multitude that needs to know your love, your peace, your hope, and your joy. And we dedicate these offerings in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
So, friends, I have a question for you. This little spring that belonged in the pen may seem insignificant, right? Do you think you're insignificant? I sure hope not. I sure hope not. Doesn't matter which part of the body we are, which gifts we share, the importance is that we do it, that we share our gifts. Because all of our gifts are valuable and important. So go from this place. Share those gifts. Share God's love. Be the church. Amen.